Okay, today in bookkeeping, I want us to look at books of original entry. We also call them books of account. In other terms also, we call them prime books. I want us to start with the elimination. Elimination of book of original entry. These are the book, the initial books where business transactions are recorded prior to posting to the ledger. Are the initial books where business transactions are recorded prior to posting. When we say prior, we mean before. Before posting them to the ledger. So the initial books, we also call them the first books. Initial means first. These are the first books where business transactions are recorded prior or before posting them to the ledger. So as we learn about the accounting process, we say we have the books of original entry, then we go to the ledger. So before you record any transaction to the ledger, first of all, you record that transaction in the book of original entry. That's why we call them the first books. Now, I want us to look at the types. Types of books of original entry. We have two main types. We have the general. We have the general journal. And we have the special journals. Last time we learned about the general journal, I want us to look at the special journals. Special journals, we have five of them. There are five. We have the sales journal, or we call them day books. We have the purchases. We have sales return, which we also call them returns inwards. Journal. We have the purchases return, which we call return outwards. Journal. Then we have the cash book. Because we have already learned about the cash book, now I want us to look at the four journals. So sales journal is a journal or is a day book where sales which were made on credit are recorded. So in the sales journal, we record only credit sales. If you sell your goods and then you receive the amount or the payment, immediately you record the cash book. So those which you sell on credit, you record the sales journal. Purchases journal. The purchases channel, you record credit purchases. You record only credit purchases. Cash purchases, you record the cash book. This one, we learned about them. Then we have returns inwards. Returns inwards, journal, you record the value of the goods which the customers return to the business. When you say return to, we mean you are brought back. So after selling, the customers may bring back some goods due to different reasons. Maybe you sold them more than what they wanted, or some of them are defects, they return the goods. So the value of that goods, you record it in the returns inwards journal. Returns outwards. Returns outwards journal. It's also used to record the goods with the business as returned to the supplier. You have recorded the purchases journal, goods which you have purchased on credit. You record the purchases journal. Then, after some time, you can realize that there are some reasons which can make you to return some of them to the supplier. So the value of the goods which you return to the supplier, you record in the returns outwards journal. We have learned about the cash book. Because it is a journal. Now the cash book, you use it to record all the transactions which involved cash. So it is used to record cash transactions. Only cash transactions. The other four, you record credit transactions. But the cash book, you record cash transactions. Let us look at the format. So the formats are two. For the first two, for the sales and the purchases journal, we have a different one. Because when you purchase or you sell goods on credit, we use invoice. But when you return the goods or the customers return the goods, we give them the credit note or a debit note. But in most cases, we use the credit note. So for the format of the sales and purchases journal, first of all, we write the name of the journal. Thank you. Then the first column we write the date of the transaction. Then the second column we write the details. Then we write the folio. Folio is the page number where you are going to record the transaction. Then we have invoice number. Then we have the amount. Amount we write in Kenya shillings. That is the format of the sales and purchases journals. Then the format of the returns. It can be either return inwards or return outwards. So you start with the name of the journal. That's the title. First column, write the date. Second, you write the details. Folio. Then now, instead of writing invoice number, now we write the credit note number. Then we have the amount. Those are the formats for the day books.